For the past couple of months, I have been running a little experiment with Facebook ads. I've been running three separate ad sets to drive traffic to Spotify. The first ad set is an ongoing growth ad set that I've been running since the beginning of the year that's just kind of pooling together Spotify followers and targeting all of the territories where Spotify was at the time currently available. The second ad set is a narrowed in ad set that is targeting all the Spotify cities where I'm getting the most traffic in the audience tab in my Spotify for artists. And then the third ad set, which is the one that I've most recently added, is an ad set that's targeting all of the countries where I'm doing the best according to my Spotify for artists. So today, what we're going to do is pick through these three different ad sets, and I'm going to share my results with you. So I've been running this ongoing growth campaign since just before the beginning of 2021. And I started out with just one ad set that was targeting all of the Spotify territories that were available at the time. I haven't added in all of the new territories that they've added this year, but I'll get to that later. And then at the beginning of March, I added a second ad set that was targeting Spotify trigger cities. And I did a video on that a couple of weeks after I started that ad set, and you can check that out right here. And then most recently, I added an ad set that I started calling Spotify Trigger Countries. So I've been running the Trigger Cities ad set for just under 2 months, and I've been running the Trigger Countries ad set for a little over 2 weeks. And now that I've been running all of this side by side for that amount of time, I think that the results are kind of starting to speak for themselves. So let's dig into Facebook ads, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So here in the Facebook ad platform, I've got these three different ad sets. Lions All Spotify, which is targeting all of the Spotify territories. I've got Lions Trigger Cities, which are all the cities that are performing the best in my Spotify for artists. And then I've got Lions Trigger Countries, which are the countries that are performing the best for me in Spotify for artists. And all three of these ad sets are using the exact same ad and the exact same lookalike and custom audiences throughout. Now, if you've followed my channel and you've watched some of my recent videos, this will look familiar to you. But basically, it's this. So if we go to this ad set here for the Trigger Countries, I've got these custom audiences and lookalike audiences. I've got one made out of ad video views, people who have viewed 95% of the ad. I've got view content, people who have actually clicked and converted. And then I've got two lookalike audiences made off of those two custom audiences. And that is the same for all of these ad sets that are currently active. So the only difference between these ad sets is the actual location targeting. As I said before, the one for the Spotify territories is for all the territories that were available when I made the ad set. Going to the Trigger Countries, if we go to my audience tab in Spotify for artists, I took basically the top 20 countries with the exception of India, and I added them all to an ad set to make my Trigger Countries ad set. And then for Trigger Cities, I went to the top cities in the audience tab and I took all 50 top cities and I put those into an ad set. Now they've probably changed around a little bit from the time I created that ad set until now because cities kind of come and go as far as listeners are concerned. But that's what I did at the time. And so these are all the results that I've gotten over the past almost 60 days of running these two ads alongside the main kind of ongoing growth campaign ad. And as you can see, the ongoing growth campaign has far and away the most views content. It's got almost 4,000 over the past 2 months. The Trigger Cities has the second most with 900. And then the Trigger Countries has the third most with a whopping 40 over 2 weeks. But here's the interesting thing that's happening. If I change the window of time here and I just go to this week, here's what's happened this week. The Trigger Cities is hardly even getting shown anymore. And the Trigger Countries is hardly getting shown anymore either. Trigger Cities has no conversions and the Trigger Countries only has 4. Now the cost per conversion is lower for the Trigger Countries than the main ad set, but it's just not getting shown. And here's why I think that is. What has happened is the results of this main ad set here, they've gotten a lot better, or I shouldn't say a lot, they've gotten better over the past 2 months. So if we go back out to this window, you can see this kind of like noticeable uptick in this ad set, which kind of is irrelevant to this March 8th, but it kind of goes along and then it gets a little bit better here, comes back down. And then at the end here, it kind of has gone up even more. So I'm getting more results at a slightly lower cost per conversion than I was before. You can see if we go to the Trigger Cities ad set here, there's this abrupt drop-off where it just stopped getting shown and stopped getting conversions. It did really well up and up and up and up, and then it kind of fell off by the wayside and just stopped getting any conversions at all. And the same for the trigger cities. It started out strong and then just boom, fell down. I think what is happening is this. By running these three ad sets alongside one another that kind of overlap audiences and use the exact same custom and lookalike audiences, I have kind of tripled the amount of data that I'm dumping into the audiences that I've created, both the custom audiences and the lookalike audiences. And so over the past 60 days, these two additional testing audiences have given a lot more better data into the lookalike audiences. And because the main ad set is using those same lookalike audiences, it is now benefiting from all of that data that the other two ad sets have added into it. And so now it is converting even better than it was before. Each of these three ad sets are targeting kind of like a narrowed in audience, but they all kind of overlap. So you've got all the Spotify territories and people are kind of already clicking through in the countries ad set. So I target in on that really tightly and it overlaps. And then I target in again on the cities and that overlaps. All of that data is just kind of reinforcing the value of these specific locations coming through. And then that's getting applied to the main ad set. So from this point, I'm going to turn off these trigger cities and trigger countries ad sets, and I'm just going to keep the main one going. But the super interesting part to me is this. I'm looking forward to testing this out with a release campaign. Now, in the past with release campaigns, I have run a lookalike ad set, a retargeting ad set, and a cold audience ad set. This time around, I'm going to do something different. I've got a new track dropping in about 2.5 weeks, and I'm going to test out these exact three ad sets, but just in release campaign format. So $50 a day on ad spend for the first 3 days, and then we'll kind of take it from there based on how it performs. I'm hoping that what will happen is kind of the same thing that has happened here on a shortened time scale. I'll get a lot of much richer data very quickly, which will hopefully lead to kind of the main ad set that's got all of the territories into it, taking all the budget and then using all of that budget much more effectively maybe than it would have without the other two ad sets assisting it. So these are the results of my little experiment that I've been running for the past 2 months. I think the trigger cities thing and the trigger countries thing is a valuable option to test out in your own targeting. I would definitely start by testing it with a growth campaign before you test a release campaign. I'd also be interested to see if any of you guys have the same results where you run it for a while and then it stops getting shown because the main ad set kind of like absorbs all of that traffic and budget. So if you want to test it out, let me know in the comments and let me know what your results are. And if you can't let me know in the comments, then maybe you can hop into this Friday's live stream at 12 p.m. Central Time and we'll talk about it there. At the end here, I got a couple videos you can check out. At the top is the original Trigger Cities video that I did, and then the bottom will be kind of whatever I decide. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.